And ladies and gentlemen, with that pizza from Fox's, hopefully you'll be tuned in to NBC when the puck drops at 8. It'll be Mike Doc Emrick with a call, Pierre Maguire, of course, along the ice, and great commentary from Eddie Olczyk. P.K. Subban, Mr. Dvorak, who joins us now on the Comcast Sports Line, said that Sidney Crosby was chirping about his bad breath. One thing's for sure, he was close enough that he could have smelled it because he was on him all night. And I think he was one of the reasons why Nashville got that win in Game 3 the other night. Good afternoon.
Yeah, what did he have to say to Jake Guentzel then? Did Guentzel question his halitosis? If the guy wants to act like Muhammad Ali on skates, that's fine with me. They haven't won anything yet, though.
Hey, talk about the transition game. Is it still where it needs to be with the Penguins, or is that suffering right now?
Well, you know what, Rob? Took the old right cross to the chin on Saturday night. There's no question about it. They knocked it down. Now, the mark of a champion is to be able to get back up. And there is no champion that hasn't at some point in their raid had to get up off the ground and rebound. So everything's got to be better. That transition game, I think he goes back to having a gritty guy on every line is a little bit of protection, because Nashville certainly isn't showing them any respect. Their strategy is to just bang them and grind them down and, play defense, which wins championships. And the Penguins they solved the Ottawa trap, so they've got to find a way to solve this, too.
You know, I was watching Channel 11 WPXI late last night. The Final Word, Albie Oxenrider, your host, John Steigerwald, Mark Madden. Mark was talking about the transition game suffering, and then they kind of started talking about the goalie situation. And Mark Madden made a very good point, saying, look, it's too late in the season to be talking about who is your number one goalie. But he and Mr. Steigerwald, a little verbal sparring back and forth. So let me ask you the question. Do they stick with Fleury, and is Murray on a short leash? Hey, listen, I know how much Mr. Dvorak likes to salute our veterans, and if you're in the Monaca area tonight, the American Legion Post 580 has a wonderful evening plan. They've got a bucket of domestics, your favorite beers, for $8.50, and you get a half a dozen wingdings for $6. And Bob, just real quick on these social halls, especially the American Legions and VFWs, why you and I are such a proponent of them, and why they really mean so much to the region. Get back to this matchup tonight. Even if the Pens were to lose and it would be tied up at 2-2 and they would shift back to Pittsburgh, really, with home ice advantage, it really is still the Penguins, I think, cup to lose.
All right.
right, ladies and gentlemen, link into one of these great watering holes. Of course, at Shewalk. The trucks are rolling today at Shewalk's Distributing. And get out your AAA East Central rally towel and let's go, Penguins. Bob Dvorak, thank you, sir. Have a great day. Enjoy the matchup tonight. Well, all I can tell you is I did my Listerine today, so it's all good in the Pratt Pack hood.
All right. I knew I could count on you, Pratt. I got your six, man. Okay.
Have a great day, everybody.